back. Current world chess champion Vishwanathan Anand was felicitated by his sponsor NIIT this afternoon. The five-time world champ arrived in his hometown last evening after successfully defending his title, beating Boris Gelfand of Israel in a tiebreaker. Anand has been the undisputed world champion since 2007, and though no sportsperson has been conferred Bharat Ratna, the All India Chess Federation is demanding that Anand be given the same.
When you want to defend your title, you want to defend it, and it doesn't matter what number it is. So it's not like I wanted to defend it less because it was the fifth one or something like that. You're there and you simply want to, you don't want to lose the match. So there are definitely no thoughts of retirement. In fact, quite the opposite. After this match, it's been a huge boost to my morale as well, and now I really want to play chess. And as long as I enjoy it, I don't see why I should stop. Like I said, on top of that, winning in Moscow meant a lot emotionally, and it's been a huge boost to my morale. So I'm, in fact, looking forward to the next series of tournaments. And it's not really about records. I think it's the fact that you love winning and you hate losing. When you go to the board, you don't care that you've won in the past or lost in the past. You simply don't want to lose. You want to win now, and that's how it is. Kasparov, well, I mean, he retired in 2005. And 2011, he's been trying to make me retire, but I don't know. So he's been announcing retirement in all of 2011. And, well, at least he should have consulted me because I'm going to disappoint him. So.
Moving on, unstable climatic conditions and insufficient rainfall hit mango production in Aurangabad of Maharashtra. Farmers said that local varieties as well as those meant for export have been suffering due to lack of rains and excessive heat. They also complained of the produce not fetching good dividends.
मेरे 500 झाड़ा हैं मेरे खुद के और ये साल में इतना बहुत खर्चा हुआ है मेरा पर वो खर्चे के वजह से खर्चा आधा आधा भी नहीं निकाल रहा उसमें मेरा वो बोले तो बहुत नुकसान हुआ है
A unique art workshop in Srinagar gave people a huge platform to showcase their artistic talent on the banks of Dal Lake. The workshop included various programs like art exhibition, dance performances and drama by local theatre artists. Organizer of the workshop, Abir Gupta, said that the motive of the workshop was to help people to exchange their ideas and exhibit their talents.
It's the great thing. And it can't be better than that because those who don't know, they will learn. And those who know, उनका काम पॉलिश हो जाएगा और कुछ लोग तो जानते भी नहीं है गयूर हसन साहब एंड द अदर आर्टिस्ट्स हु आर डूइंग इट वो मतलब वो वाकई में हैं जो आके देखेंगे तो यू नो इससे अच्छा क्या हो सकता है यहाँ के लिए
A hand-drawn copy of the cover of Tintin in America retained its title of the most expensive comic ever sold at a public auction when it was bought for over 1.3 million euros by a private collector. The sale of memorabilia of the famous Belgian comic book took place at a central Paris auction house and featured a wide variety of lots, including rare first editions, original drawings and toys. Britain's Queen Elizabeth Diamond Jubilee celebrations crossed the Atlantic yesterday. Virgin Atlantic Airways attempted to turn New York's Union Square into Union Jack Square, in honor of the Queen's special anniversary. The airline hosted a competition for anyone who can make one of the poker-faced Queen's guards laugh. And the winners would win a chance for a free plane ticket. Several tried their luck with little success, however. The Royal Guard was no match for a young girl who teased him into submission.
She's going in for the kill.
We've got one of the Queen's guards here who doesn't laugh. So we're trying to get the public, they have 1 minute to make the guard laugh and then they get put through some sort of competition for a free flight, for a flight from New York to London.
And that brings us to the end of this bulletin. Stay tuned to NDTV Hindu for more news and updates.